गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द पोयम मनी मैडनेस रिटन बाय डी एच लॉरेंस। सो ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट द पोएट डी एच लॉरेंस। ही वॉज बॉर्न इन 1885 एंड वॉज डाइड इन 1930। वॉज अ प्रोमिनेंट एंड प्रोलिफिक 20th century English writer. He has to his credit several novels, short stories, poems, plays, essays, travel books and translation. Particularly noted for his psychological bent, his novels, especially Sons and Lovers, The Rainbow, Woman in Love and Lady Chatterley's Lover have created a niche for him in modern English literature as works that dealt with the complexities of human relationship. So, dear student, you should underline the work of D.H. Lawrence, which was very famous, with deals with the complexities of human relationship. That novels are Sons and Lovers, Rainbow, Woman in Love, and Lady Chatterley's Lover. These are some novels you should write it down. Then brief information about the author. Money Madness is simple poem that deals with what Lawrence perceives means he is observe as the materialistic perspective, point of view of his fellow human beings. It is different from most of his other poems in that it is an objective examination of very relevant issues. The poem was originally published in 1929 in collection Pansies. You should also write it down, that particular poem Money Madness was published in 1929 and in the collection of poems named Pansies. It is widely regarded as an indictment, we can say it is a criticism or indictment of common notions means the way of looking at, way of looking towards something or someone, notion of capitalist society which is immersed in the collective madness of materialism. The possession of money seems to insulate people from each other. Insulate means we can say isolate from each and other, and its absence terrifies them. The Lawrence suggests that money is capable of manipulating human beings into committing act of injustice and oppression. So basically this background of this particular poem, we observe the duration of D.H. Lawrence. It is between 1885 to 1930. In that particular period, there was the emergence of the industrialization in Europe, and we know very well when as far as our Chandrapur city is concerned, we have the various suburbs areas, slum areas, in which the people gathered all around the villages to get their livelihood. So what happens then, they just come from their own hometown or home village to city life only to get money. At the same time, there are also some industrialist persons, they also just keep the motto of gaining much and more money, and that tendency to get more and more money makes the human being like animal, a greedy animal who just wanted to eat more and more. In the same way, when we are totally engulfed or we are totally infatuated or attracted towards money, and that our greed, we can generally say that greed of possessing more and more money leads to human being to cheat other, to oppress other, also to do something injustice towards other. Means we just forget about our humanity, and as a human being we have to we have to behave in society, or we have to treat our fellow companion, all that we just wanted to grab money by cheating others. such type of tendency we can generally find out after the emergence of industrialization. Before that, there were also the import of some money, because without money we cannot live. As we have to live, we have to eat, we have to wear clothes, we have to eat bread and butter and whatever the foods. That's why we must have the money. But excesses of greediness that emerged after the emergence of industrialization, we can say, and that was emerged in European countries. And how we know very well how the greed of accumulating more and more money forced them to we can say win the half of the world. Just we think about the particularly England, Britain at that time. They had their empire all over the world, and they just founded the various colonies there, and there was only motto to grab, to accumulate more and money to their countries. So that was the industrialization that made the people money minded. So this particular poem is very easy, and when we go through this particular poem, we will see the language is not so complex, or just prose like language has been used here. So it is a very simple poem, but that compel us to think over that matter, how the money is important, but excesses greed of money can lead us towards the brutishness. Money is our madness, and our vast collective madness. Money is our madness, a madness of individual. It is also the madness of collective masses. Collective masses means that money madness we generally find in all over the world, all over the whole society. And each and every individual living on this earth has been, we can say, attracted towards that collecting much and more and more monies. And of course, if the multitude means the masses, if the multitude is mad, then individual carries his own grain of insanity around with him. And multitude means the whole nation, whole countries, whole human being on this earth is totally mad because they wanted to get more and more money. At the same way, that caste impel the individual also to get more and money, because that individual has fear that one day he will not be able to buy the bread for his family, and he will die without that. And that's why he is also has also the fear about not keeping that much money with him. And I doubt if any man living hands out a pound note without a pang. I doubt if any man living, hands out means give, a pound note without a pang. Pang means just feeling of sadness, we can say here are giving. Pang means the sharp, intense pain and distress. So the poet doubts that, is there any man who will give a pound note without getting sad or without getting unhappy? No, there is no one on this whole universe that he doubts that. But we also find in our society some generous people who are always ready to help other, but poets doubt that if there is any one person who will give out £1 note without without pang or without sadness or without and a real tremor if he hands out the £10 note. Even if there is no one, the poet doubts that, the who will give a £1 note without giving getting pang. But if he gives the £10 notes, there will be the tremor, the last, the vast, we can say, the large disaster in his life can come. He just will behave like that, the disaster has come in his life. And we quail, money makes us quail. Quail means the tremble, lose heart, tremble. We just feel sad when we lose the money. We quail, money makes us quail, it has got us down. We grovel before it in the strange stare. No wonder, for money has the fearful, cruel power among men. And when we have not money, we just feel sad, we just feel terrified, we just feel we just live in terror that we will not be able to buy some bread and butter for our families, and that we just that money has that much power, cruel power we can say, among men, and that creates the fearful situation in the life of human being. But it is not money we are terrified of, it is a collective money madness of mankind. So money madness means we must earn some money at some proportion to get our livelihood. But there are people who are mad towards the money. That madness is terrified. That madness, money in itself is not terrified, but to get more and more money, that is the main motto of humankind. That madness is terrified. For mankind say with no voice, how much he is he worth? Has he no money? Then let him eat dirt and go cold. Go cold means die. If someone has not money to get his livelihood, to get his bread and butter, he will be compelled to eat dirt and be cold means to die. And if he has not money, one day he will be compelled to eat dirt and ultimately die. And that is the fear about money. That for that it means that we must have some money to get our livelihood, to get our proper we can say bread and butter. But the excesses of money, the greediness to get much and more and more money, that cost the formidable disaster we can say. If we have no money, they will give me a little bread so I do not die, but they will make me eat dirt for it, and I shall have to eat dirt, and I shall have to eat dirt. And if I have no money, I shall have to eat dirt. And that is fear of eating dirt that makes the people mad, that makes the people fearful. And there will be someone who will help me little, but that will also let me to eat dirt means that will cause the degradation in my status. That is the fear of, if I have no money, there will be the degradation of my status. That is the degradation of fear of degradation of status. That fear is also most important, and because of that fear, we generally wants to get more and more money. It is that I am afraid of that the fear can become a delirium. Delirium means the hallucination. We just think very badly, and that hallucinations about what will happen if I am not, I have not that much money with my. It is that I am afraid of, and the fear can become a delirium. It is fear of my money mad fellow man, and it is fear about the money mad fellow. The when we observe the people around us, the getting more and more money, and they if we have the only person, we have not that much money, and they will compel us to eat dirt means, and that will be the degradation in our status, and that's the degradation also cause the much fear in the mind of individual. We must have some money to save us from eating dirt. We must have, as a human being, the money is most important thing in our life. But that not much that for the money we can murder, we have to murder someone, or we have to teach someone, or we have to do some injustice towards someone. Whatever we can earn, we must earn to maintain our status as a respectful person in the society. But for that also money is most, if we want to maintain our status, maintain our dignity in living in the society, for that we must have some money with us. But to save us from the eating dirt means to save us from degrading our status, and this is wrong. Bread should be free, shelter should be free, fire should be free to all and anybody all over the world. And for that poet demands that there should be bread, butter and shelter should be free for all human being, and that may not cause the people behave madly. and we must regain our, and that that question was asked in the last examination, what demands the particular poet in this particular poem. So you should keep in mind that bread should be free, shelter should be free, and fire should be free to all and everybody, all and anybody all over the world. This is the demand of the poet while writing this particular poem. And we must regain our sanity and about money, and before we start killing one another about it, and it's one thing or the other. And so lastly, poet says that we must gain that sanity, that wisdom, that money is important in our life, but not so important, that not much important, and that may compel us to murder or cheat our fellow human being, or start killing another about it. Because money is important, but not the important than, not more important than the lives of other. And that type of wisdom we must gain while living in this world. Okay, if you, I think this is very simple poem and prose like poem. That's if still you come across some difficulties, please let me know on our group. Thank you.